What's going on? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Isaac Leffler. Today we'll be listening to The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill by Miss Lauryn Hill. I've heard a lot of talk about this album. Everybody said it's one of the greatest albums, really, of all time. People love this album. People love Lauryn Hill. I have no knowledge of anything she's ever done or any of her work, so I'm very excited going into this with a pure blank slate. Not even, like, I couldn't name anything Lauryn Hill has ever done. I just know the name. I know that she has a very dedicated fan base. This album came out in 1998. Before I was born, so without further ado, let's get right into it with intro.
Valdez, Gabrielle Salado, Latoya Bradbury, Antoine Mitchell, Shaquan, Tamika Marshall.
A little roll call action going. I feel like I'm in school right now.
Lauryn Hill.
Pretty cool track. Didn't seem like much going on there. Like I said, it's not a kind of like a roll call thing, like they're in the classroom. Obviously, the highlight on her name, it felt like everything was a lot of noise when he said Lauryn Hill. It was clear. You were able to hear it very easily. So yeah, just kind of highlighting who the album's by. I think to tie it into the title, it says The Miseducation. When you think education, you think roll calls like that. So yeah, let's go into the next track, The Lost Ones. Here we go.
It's funny how money changes situation. Miscommunication leads to complication. My emancipation don't fit your equation. I was on the humble, you on every station. Someone play young love conversation. Who you gonna scrimmage like you the champion? You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might
like win that. Some, but you just lost one. A lot going on right there. You might win some, but you just lost one. Feels very layered right there. You might win some, but you just lost one.
Turn cold, gain the whole world for the price of your soul. Trying to grab hold of what you can't contain. Yeah, slick talk on the day of judgment. The movement's similar to a serpent. Try to play straight how your whole style been. Consequences, no coincidence. The crits always want to play like innocent. Yeah. Always want to take it to the full out extent. Always want to make it seem like good intent.
But you really lost one.
Okay, of course. Good voice. When it's all done, did you really versatile already. She's strong vocal. Like this right here. You might win some, but you really lost one. You just lost one. It's so silly. You lost one. You just lost one. It's so you just lost one. You just lost one. You just lost one. What a bomb bomb. Bit of a skit.
What's that?
Love.
What?
Love.
How many people know any songs about love?
Right here.
I know a lot about love.
Tell me some titles. What's some song?
Love.
It's a song called Love.
Yeah,
it's no song called
Love. It's by Kirk Franklin.
All right, what is it? How I go?
It goes Love.
Titanic.
Romeo and Juliet.
Did you know that was about love when you saw that on TV? They said it was about love.
All right, Lost Ones. That was a cool track. It's a really strong chorus. Obviously, I didn't know this. I didn't know anything about Lauryn Hill. She's got a very good voice, strong vocals throughout. She has some interesting enunciation at points that I'm gonna throw it out there. I think it kind of reminds me of Kendrick Lamar, where it's like making words more interesting just by the way she, like, if you know what, I'm assuming you guys know what enunciation is, but it's just the way you say the word and how it flows throughout the song. She did a really good job on that. If you guys know me, you know I don't particularly love skits all that much, but this one served a purpose. It kind of sounded like a class lesson again, and if we're talking about the miseducation, we're talking about education, ties into the theme of what the title is about, so that makes sense. If we're just talking about the name of the song, Lost Ones, it's sounding like it's like you just lost one. It sounds like she's talking to somebody, maybe a relationship, and saying how they just lost a good one. Like maybe she's talking about herself, more than likely I'm thinking she is. And she's saying, you know, he's lost a good one. Let's go to the next one. X Factor. Here we go. I like the piano in the background.
It could all be so simple. But you found me who I had to gain so reciprocity. See, no one loves you more than me, and no one ever will. No one ever will. No matter how I think we grow, you always see.
I like this. I like that. Of course, it's awesome. Love song. How can I explain? This is where that sample's from? Is this the Drake song? Oh, fuck. I feel stupid. Oh man, that's cool. I didn't know that.
And no one ever will. No matter how I think we grow, you always seem to let me know. It ain't working. It ain't working. It ain't working. It ain't working. When I try to walk away, you hurt yourself to make me see.
This is a good song. This is the fucking Drake song. I can't believe I didn't know this. Obviously, this is where it comes from. So it's not Drake's song, but this is what Drake said. That sounds awesome. It's like lifting. Who was that on the guitar solo? Doesn't say. So that sounded like, obviously, a love song, but it sounded like there was a situation where just they knew it wasn't going to work, and it was causing a lot of heartache for Miss Lauryn Hill. Where it's just like, she was talking about, never had so much pain, like, you're causing so much pain, never had anybody do this to me. The chorus where it says, no matter how I think we grow, you always seem to let me know, it ain't working, it ain't working, it ain't working, it ain't working. And when I try to walk away, you'd hurt yourself to make me stay, saying like, it's a toxic relationship. She was ahead of her time, talking about toxicity. She beat Brent Faiyaz way to the punch, where she's just talking about, like, you're doing all this crazy shit to just keep me involved with you. So, I also think, since it's talking about the last song where we had Lost Ones, we had X Factor, talk about breakups. So, I think this is kind of like a X Factor. Like, I think the X is like a play on ex-girlfriend. So, it's like you're the factor of, like, you have an ex and I'm the ex, maybe. I didn't realize that was the Nice For What. I didn't realize that's where Nice For What the sample came from. That makes this even better because it was just a pleasant surprise. That was a great track. Let's go on to the next track, though, which is To Zion, with a feature that I wasn't expecting to see from Carlos Santana. I am a big Carlos Santana fan. I don't know many of his songs, but I know my dad likes him. He has a very distinct sound to his guitar, so yeah, I'm excited. Long track, 6 minutes. Here we go. It's going to be another slower song.
One day.
Love Santana.
Came one day, told me to kneel down and pray.
for unto me a man child would be born. Oh, this crazy circumstance, I knew his life deserved a chance. Foreign baby, you
head. But telling her not to have the kid?
I chose to use my heart. Now the joy of my world is in Zion. Now the joy. See, life for you, my prince, has just begun. And I thank you for choosing me to come through unto life to be a beautiful.
What is that in the background? Like a ukulele? I can't tell it is. Ooh, I like that. I like the choir right there. Santana right there, yeah. Collecting my thoughts. Sorry if I went blank there.
All right. Oh, let this black man right here tell what his idea of love is. Because now all the time we hear young black men talk about love. About your personal definition. Don't tell me what Webster thinks. Huh?
Willing to do everything for that person.
Okay, everything like what? Explain. Let him talk, come on. If I ask him to talk about a fancy car, he'd be right on point. But you want to talk about love. You can do it. What do you think? You said you love somebody, you should know why you love them, right?
Fucking in front of the boys and they get around and they say they love you. They can't love you.
Because
love wouldn't do that.
It's love is not phony. To Zion, that was a cool track. First off, I want to say Santana was amazing throughout the song. I think he just adds like a different kind of oomph whenever he's in a song like this. It's hard for me to explain about the, like, I don't know, he just feels like he's perfectly meshing in with the tone of the song where, like, she's talking about, first off, let's just go into what she's talking about. Initially, she's talking about how maybe her label or, like, manager saying, you know, this is going to be a big change in your life, having a kid. Like, having a kid's a big deal. They're saying, you know, like, look at your career. They're like, a baby, use your head, come on. And then she said she chose her heart instead. So it sounded like they were asking her not to have the kid. And then she's like, no, I'm going to have this kid. So Zion is obviously her kid. So it sounds like this is a message to her kid. She just showed off her vocal performance, like, throughout the whole song, how much she loves this kid who she's going to have and how much she's going to enjoy him being in her life. In the end, the outro was super, super long. It was like marching, marching to Zion. Marching, marching. So I immediately thought of the march to Mount Zion, which is like a spiritual, religious kind of thing that they do. And it's a journey. It's like a rite of passage almost. And I think that's kind of what they were talking, like what she was trying to get at in the song, where like this is a spiritual journey. Like once she's giving birth to her child, and she's going to have to care for this child, and they're going to be the center of her life for pretty much for the rest of her life. So I think it's like her saying that, and yeah, it's like how much of a journey and a change this is for her. Also, I think this song will hit exponentially harder when I'm a parent, just because like I'm not a parent right now. I'm 21 years old. Like it's hard for me to relate to like the emotions of having a child and bringing a child into the world. So I think it'll hit harder once I'm that age. And yeah, at the end there was a skit in the classroom talking about love and people's ideas of love, which I thought was cool. Again, classroom tying into education. So yeah, interesting song. Let's go to the next song, Doo-Wop. Let's get into it.
Yo, remember yo. Back on the Bully when cats used to harmonize, yeah. Like,
all right,
yo.
Ooh. Wait, this is another one. This is a Kanye's album. This one from Donda. I don't know which one that is. Okay, this sounds awesome.
give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really
good baseline.
Like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you give it up so easy, you ain't even fooling him. If you did it then, and you offer you again. You know I only said because I'm truly genuine. Don't be a hard rock when you really are a gem, baby girl. Respect is just a minimum.
This is awesome. You're still defending
him now. Lauren is only human. Don't think I haven't been.
Watch out. Oh my gosh, her voice is so good.
The second verse is dedicated to the man more concerned with his voice. The red drink come again. And since you ain't come again.
This is from Donna. Obviously not, if you guys know what I'm saying. I'm just saying. Great. Look, it's strong. That is tough. That's a tough track. That's a tough track.
For me, I'm an adult. I say, wait, you too young to be in love. This is silly. You're infatuated with him. He got nice jeans. He wear fancy Adidas. I mean, it might be something I don't know.
True.
Go ahead.
If you taking that person for what he or she is, no matter what he or she look like, or no matter what he or she do. You make that person like, I'm
you fall in love, you can fall out of love.
I just love somebody. You might stop being in love with.
She killed it. We can end that conversation with that, right?
That thing. That was awesome. So the beat was tough. Awesome bass line. Kanye sampled that for Donda. I'm looking up what song that was. He sampled it for Believe What I Say. That's where I had heard that sample before. Obviously, this album was very well received by a lot of important people because if Drake and Kanye are both sampling Miss Lauryn Hill, she must be pretty damn good. This album has been pretty damn good. And just sometimes when there's like a sample, it doesn't hit the same. Like sometimes I almost feel like it's better when it's sampled. Hers, they're better in her own songs by far. That's something to keep in mind when I'm just listening to this. Is like I'm enjoying this better than the song that from artists that I know better, that I know I enjoy. I'm enjoying her version much, much better. So that's good. Yeah, chorus was incredible and very catchy. Like as you just saw me singing, that thing. Like that's super catchy. And then the skit, there's a powerful little saying right there in the skit where she goes, there's a difference from loving somebody and being in love with somebody. On the surface level, you'd be like, yeah, that's of course, that's how it goes. But like when you love somebody, like I love my grandmother, I love my mom, I love my family, but being in love with somebody is like giving a piece of your heart to them, is significant other being like, okay, this is a very core part of myself that I'm handing over to you as a part of me showing my caring for you, my love for you. So yeah, I thought that was cool. Again, another class skit tying back into the education theme. Let's go to the next song, Superstar. Here we go.
Yo, hip hop started out in the heart. Now, baby, come on. Now, baby, come on. Now, baby, come on.
Okay.
Come on. Now, baby, come on. Now, baby, come on.
Everything you drop is so tired.
Everything.
Music is so
sophisticated. Yeah.
On exactly what an artist should be. Should they be someone with
now who you know without any flaw?
Who you know without any flaw?
That lives above a spiritual law.
That lives above
okay.
A spiritual law. Everything you drop is so tired.
Everything you drop is so tired.
Music is supposed to inspire.
What are we here for?
How come we ain't getting
beef with freaks as my album sales peak. All I wanted was to sell like 500 and be a ghetto superstar since my first album blunted. I used to work at Foot Locker, they fired me in front it. Or I quit it, now I spit it. However do you want it, now you get it. Right in rhyme, the range with the frames lightly tinted. And send it to your block and have my full name in a minute. And
I come on, baby.
Everything you drop is so tired.
Everything you drop is so tired.
Music is supposed to inspire. So how come we ain't getting no higher?
We ain't no higher.
Okay, Superstar, that was an interesting track. Some things that stuck out to me. I think her voice just kind of reminds me of soul music. I was wondering if the song was like inspired by soul music, but I don't really know if it was. But I'll see if I can tie it back into what I thought about the song. So what throughout the song, she's talking about like what makes an artist, like how artists are supposed to make music that inspires. And that's just like her personal philosophy. And then she talks about how her fame and stuff is like getting in the way of that. It's like saying, I know you think that you've got it all and you're making other people feel small. Makes you think you're unable to fall. But when you do, who are you going to call? Saying like you're on top of the world. She's at peak superstardom. Kind of like the name of the song. And it's just affecting her in a way that like, maybe she's talking to somebody actually. She's like, we're supposed to make music that inspires. Maybe she's talking to like a label person or like somebody telling her what to do, like saying, I want to do it this way and you're trying to make me do it a different way. You're taking away from my artistry. I think you can kind of see that. I guess if I wanted to say it was soul inspired, you could kind of tie it in where it's like artistry, like when you make a video, you make a movie, you make music, you're giving a piece of yourself or your soul and you're putting it out there for people to view, listen, watch, judge, comment on. Yeah, so maybe that's what I was subconsciously getting at there with this soul inspired thing. So the next song, Final Hours. Here we go.
I treat this like my thesis. Drop it. Your whole crew microscopic. Like particles while I make international articles and all that stuff. Don't discuss the baby mother business. I've been in this dirty already. Or still, people feel. Lauren Hill from New York to Israel. And this is real. So I keep making the street ballads while you looking for dressing to go with your tall salad. You get the money. Get the power. Yeah, to be in it for a minute, then run for Senate. Make a slumlord be the tenant. Give his money to kids to spend it. And then a minute, every law to never prevent it. Our survival, our rival, documented in the Bible like Moses and Aaron. Things will change, it's apparent. And all transparent. Gonna be seen through. Let God redeem you. Keep your eyes on. The final hour, you can get the money. You can get the power. Keep your eyes on. The final hour. Bread, sipping man and Chevy's wine. Paint on my party like it's 1999. But when it come down, the ground beat like Palestine. The fella still be in the church of Lalabella singing hymns a cappella, whether posed the Marabella in couture or collective residual on the score. I'm making sure I'm with the 144.
This
ain't a battle, this is war. Word to Booney.
Is that a flute in the background? Like this song is fucking crazy.
Every ghetto community had opportunity. Went from hood shock to you can get the money. The power, keep your eyes on. The final hour.
Horns back on the brass.
Get the money, get the power. Keep your eyes on. The final hour. Get the money.
First off, chorus, again, amazing. The entire time throughout the song, she's just showing her lyrical prowess as a rapper. I did not know she had this deep of a bag because there was a point in there I was like, holy fuck, she is better than 95% of every rapper that is I've ever listened to. I'm going to be honest. Where is that one part? Okay, it's all of verse 3. Now I'll be breaking bread, sipping Mashewitz wine. Pay no mind like it's 1999. When it comes down to ground beef like Palestine, say your rhymes. Let's see if you get out your bind. Now I'm going to get the mozzarella like a Rockefeller. Still be in the Church of La Bella. Singing the rhymes a cappella. Like, goodness, that's just bar after bar after bar after bar. It's crazy. And there was a couple times, this is totally different, there was a couple times throughout the song where she was mentioning just underprivileged neighborhoods and growing up in poverty and the hood. And she's, one of the parts was, I think she goes, make a slum lord be repentant, give his money to kids to spend it, and amendment every law that ever prevented our survival since our arrival, documented in the Bible like Moses and Aaron. Things are gonna change, it's apparent. I think that's just saying like how for a long time black people in the United States were just being, there were laws literally just inhibiting them from making progress as a community. I think she's pointing at that. Get diplomatic immunity in every ghetto community, had opportunity, went from hood shock to hood chick, but it ain't what you chop, it's about what you keep. And even if there are leaks, you can't capsize the ship because I baptize my lips every time I take a sip. What is diplomatic immunity? It's a legal contract between governments ensuring the safety and passage of a diplomat from a host country to another country. I'm not really sure what she's getting at there. Had the opportunity from hood, went from hood shock to hood chic. I think that's how she said it. So she went from just seeing crazy things happening in the hood she grew up in to chic is like a word for like fanciness, right? So like it's very chic, isn't that a thing? So maybe like she's leveled up in her life through her talent and through her ability to make music. And then she's showing right there at the end, she says, it's not about what you buy, cop for yourself. It's about what you keep. Like maybe how you keep your money, don't waste it. So final hours, that was fucking awesome. Go to the next song. When It Hurts So Bad. Here we go.
When it hurts so bad,
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 why does it feel so good?
When it hurts so bad, when it hurts so bad,
I love real, real hard ones. But I love the young. If you don't catch it, and what you need, ironically, will turn out what you want to be. If you just let it,
if you just let it,
if you just let it,
if you just let it.
All that I had, but how you, but who ever knew the voodoo you do?
Voodoo. Interesting.
Well, that was a classic kind of like R&B song talking about love. She's talking about like a failed relationship throughout the song where she's tried a lot to try to fix everything, trying to mend the situation of whatever situation's going on, but it's just not working. And I think that little chorus or refrain at the end just shows like what she's talking about throughout the song. She's like, when it hurts so bad, it hurts so bad. When it hurts so bad, when it hurts so bad, why does it feel so good when it hurts so bad? She's talking about it feels good being in love with the person, maybe physically with the person, but the emotional damage, this relationship as a whole is not good, but this one part is good. So she's like holding on, maybe I can fix it, but So it's really just like a lost cause. And then the skit, tying it with the education theme from this classroom, you can kind of see what she's getting at here, where one of the kids says, "It's like people think they love somebody when they don't really love somebody. Like, I thought I was in love with this girl, but I really wasn't." So pretty much saying like it's a lust, not a love kind of thing, where it's like, okay, I want to be with this person, you know, be with this person, but I don't want to be with this person, if that makes sense. So yeah, that's what I gathered from that song. Solid track. I like that track a lot, actually. Go to the next song. "I Used to Love Him" featuring Mary J. Blige. Heard the name, but don't know if I don't know any of her songs, but let's get into it.
Now I don't. I used to.
Yeah. How many things I pray the Father will forgive. And I was the same. He stole my heart like a thief in the night.
Wasted and used, reached a crossroads, which path would I choose?
Stuck and frustrated, I waited deep in.
That was an interesting track. So what I really gathered from that track was, I initially said it kind of sounded funky. It did kind of sound funky, I feel like, but it was still more like R&B at the end of the day. They're both talking about how their hearts were stolen by a man, how they were heavily infatuated with this a man in their life, and how they would really just do anything for them. I thought that was interesting to hear that from the woman's perspective, because I just feel like I don't hear many female artists talk about that. I hear a lot of male artists saying like, she's a ride or die, she's always by my side, that kind of stuff. It's not often I hear females, especially in hip-hop, R&B, rap, whatever you want to call it, talk about their passion for the man in their life. So I thought that was interesting. Mary J. Blige was talking about, "I chose the road of passion and pain, sacrificed too much and waited in vain, seized being queen, addicted to love like a drug of a fiend." Saying like she gave all of her power in the relationship. She gave up being like a powerful queen, like I guess that means like self-confident, in whatever way that she's talking about, just how she feels truly herself. And then she gave that all up for love and whoever she was interested in, which was interesting. A lot of repeated lyrics, like the chorus came in a couple times. There was a long outro, but overall, that was a solid track. Let's go into the next one, Forgive Them, Father. Here we go.
Forgive us our trespasses, although them again we will never, never, never trust. But them do, they go to yai while I'm sticking like glue.
What accent is that?
Forgive them, Father, for
sound like a Jamaican.
They know not what Father for. They know not what they do.
For real, them not a clue.
Beware the false motives, and you never suppose it's those who are closest to you. Decision, they use your kindness as their ammunition to shoot on.
Like an organ in the background?
Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do.
Every Indian wanna be the chief. Be the man till he full and he still want me. Just don't turn the other cheek, but I try to keep it civilized like Menelik and other Africans are. Observing stars with war scars. Get yours in this capitalistic system. So many quarter got what you can't list them. How you gonna march through these streets like Soweto?
Like Cain and Abel, Caesar and Brutus.
It's a lot of biblical and historical references. Yeah, I've noticed that.
Let's do this.
Okay, she's definitely Jamaican.
Them are your friend who you depend on from way
back. Oh, yeah.
If you give them your back, then you must meet your end. Them don't know what them do. Them don't know what them do. Them don't know what them do.
I like that organ right there.
Like, oh, you want to know what they think.
What she feels is important to you.
Right.
Huh?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I want her to still love me. But, you know. I know she still like me because, you know.
Okay, that song kind of like had an islandy feel to me. That girl at the end was definitely Jamaican, so I think it was like maybe I was getting like a Jamaican Islander kind of feel to the song. I couldn't really catch what she meant in the chorus. Forgive them, Father. Like, I heard a lot of biblical references. I don't know if it's a biblical reference. I'm going to click on Genius to see what they're saying. Saying she's referring to Luke 23:34, which quotes Jesus' prayer to God as he is being crucified, asking that God forgive those responsible for said crucifixion. Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing, and they divided up his clothes by casting lots. Says Jesus was sympathetic enough to know those who betrayed him, knew no better. Lauren knows that those who've wronged her are only victims to their own ignorance. Okay, that's interesting. I like that a lot. I don't have a lot of comments on that song. I just enjoyed it. It was an easy listen right there. That was a real easy listen. Let's go to the next song, Every Ghetto, Every City. Here we go.
Any legs and press and curl. My mother always thought I'd be a star.
Oh, this one's funky.
Streets that nurtured Lauren. Every ghetto, every city, and suburban place. Story starts in
Hooterville.
Grew up next to Ivy Hill when kids were stealing quarter deals for fun. Stop it. Made me recall my days in the New Jerusalem. You know it's hot. Don't forget what you got. Look at God.
Sounds like Stevie Wonder to me. That's what this reminded me of.
Looking back,
bag of bonbons, 20 cents and a nickel. Well, Springfield Lab had the best popsicles. Saturday morning cartoons and kung fu.
What the? Okay. Yeah. Like
Main Street, Wu's Tonic with the dress. When Doug Fresh and Slick Rick was together, looking at the crew, we thought we'd all live forever. Yeah, you know it's hot. You don't forget. But when Hawthorne and Chancellor had beef, moving records was on Central Lab.
Yeah.
I was there at
like
dancing
that.
School. South on Jab at Ball and Pool. Unaware of what we did and had. Writing my friends' names on my jeans with the amp up the party. I wish those days they didn't stop. Every ghetto, every city and suburban place I've been. Man, we recall our days in every city. Looking back, looking back, looking back. You know it's hot, don't forget.
This song has nostalgia. I'll explain why I think so in a second.
Looking back, looking back, looking back, looking back, looking back, looking back, looking back.
Okay, Lord. Hello? Yo.
How'd he say it like
he's
that?
He's about to give us a dissertation. The way he said that. Go ahead. Break down, break down.
Love is just a feeling.
Okay.
You just hope they feel the same way like you did think towards them.
Okay, first I need to see what New Jerusalem is. New Jerusalem is slang for New Jersey. Lauren is saying this because her hometown is South Orange, New Jersey. New Jerusalem is slang. Oh, okay. So New Jerusalem is New Jersey. So she's saying everywhere she's going reminds her of New Jersey, which I think is why it sounded like she was just recounting a whole bunch of moments in her life where she was growing up. So this makes more sense now. It's all fixing together in my head. So that's why this song kind of felt like it had nostalgia to me then, because she's just recounting her life of where she grew up and how everything she's doing reminds her every ghetto, every city and suburban place I've been make me recall my days in New Jerusalem. Back home, everywhere she goes reminds her of back home. So everything, she just sees those moments. And then at the end, obviously, you're saying looking back, looking back, looking back, looking back. That's obviously looking back on the past of where she grew up as a kid, what she was doing, what her life was like. So this, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. Yeah, this kind of just had like a happy, happy feeling to the song, honestly. Like a happy-go-lucky song. And then I like that little kid at the end. He goes, love. Like, I even laughed, too, because just, like, the way he said it, I was like, oh, and then the teacher, spot on. Sounds like he's about to give us a whole dissertation, so. Every ghetto, every city. Solid track. So the next one, it's called Nothing Even Matters. This one has a feature from D'Angelo. Don't know who D'Angelo is, but here we go.
Skies could fall, not even if my boss should call. The world, it seems so very small.
It sounds like a song you're doing business.
Nothing even matters at all. See, nothing even matters. See, nothing even matters at all.
Nothing even matters. Nothing even matters at all.
These buildings could drift out to sea. Some natural catastrophe. Still, there's no place I'd
to look at you religiously, baby. Cause nothing even matters to me. Nothing even matters. Nothing even matters to me.
Now you won't find me at no store. I have no time for manicures. With you, it's never either.
To me.
One more time.
To me.
like the snaps in the background. Nothing Even Matters is a song where I'm kind of realizing what Lauryn Hill's good at. She's not trying to disguise what her songs are about. She's being very straightforward, and it just feels like the tone of this song and the theme of this song, blind love, and how like love will blind you and make you do crazy things. I want to be honest, it sounds like a song you do business to again, but again, like I said, that's what I got from there. Things that I liked throughout during the song, the snaps were a cool addition. There was a very good organ player throughout the song, and then I thought I heard like wind chimes at one point. Just a cool addition, an interesting thing to add to the track. Overall though, Nothing Even Matters, simple, straightforward track, but beautifully executed. Loved it. D'Angelo had a very good voice as well. Yeah, overall, just solid all the way around. Let's go to the next track. Everything Is Everything. Here we go.
Yo, we about to check.
They have a tone switch up, I think.
On the tomb of Nefertiti, MCs ain't ready to take it to the Serengeti. My rhymes is heavy, like the mind of Sister Betty. L boogie spars with stars and constellations. Then scripture develop a negative into a positive picture.
Everything is everything. What is meant to be, will be. Must come spring.
That one was very good. It was definitely a tone switch up. So she had been talking about love a lot. And now she goes back to, it sounded like the beginning, she was just talking about the system being set up against people that come from low-income areas, like people, minorities, and how they're just already put behind the eight ball because of how things are set up and how it's just set up against them, or it's harder for them to come up and make a way for themselves. There was a really good, like, powerful piano kind of going throughout the whole song. Drums in the background were very, very good. Her voice, she was showing off her vocals. This song was also very, very impressive. I'm going to look at Genius because I just feel like I'm probably missing some stuff. Apparently, the piano was played by John Legend, who at the time was Unknown. Oh, that's very interesting. Okay, so that's John Legend. How about that? Solid track. I don't know the replay value of that one personally. I like it in the context of the album. I just don't know how often I would come back to it because, yeah, I just don't know. I just don't know how often I would come back to it. Let's go to the next one, though. The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill, title of the album. Here we go.
So tight that I can't breathe. And every time I've tried to
voice
be
is amazing.
Cheap, but deep in my heart, the answer mine to define my own destiny. So many cry for help, searching outside of themselves. Now I know that his strength, it wasn't me. And I've made up my mind. And deep in my heart.
Wow. Something that stuck out to me, the piano was beautiful, definitely carried the song. It's like a sensual kind of sounding, beautiful kind of sounding melody intro with her voice. And then towards the middle and the end, the organ was a good contributor throughout the song. And then her vocal performance is off the charts. It's incredible. I'm looking at Genius here, and there's a whole explanation of the song from her. So I'm just going to read that. It is straight from Lauryn Hill. I want to tell you guys a little bit more about the song that means a great deal to me. The song is called The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill, and it has a lot to do with how I figured out some things in my life. It doesn't necessarily mean miseducation, like I didn't do well in school as I did good in school. But it has a lot to do with finding out about your own aspirations and your own dreams, and not those dreams and those aspirations that some might have for you. It's a song about the movement and growth and inspiration. I want to encourage all those who are moving from one period to another, especially those graduating from one stage to another in life, whether that be school or any life lesson in general. I encourage you to be strong, independent, positive, and to know you can choose your own destiny and your own path. Stay positive, you guys. God bless you all. Thank you for all the support. That was awesome. Okay, so it's just like a rite of passage kind of song. That's cool. Go to the next track. Can't Take My Eyes Off You. Also known as I Love You, Baby. Here we go.
You're just too good to be true, for mine. At long last, love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. But in the way that I stand, there's nothing else.
I need
you, baby. If it's quite alright, I need you, baby. I love you, baby.
Oh my God. God, her voice is so fucking good.
Oh, baby, let me love you. Oh, baby. Bye. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. I need you, baby. And if it's quite all right, I need you, baby. To warm the lonely night. Let me love you.
Felt like a classic kind of song. Just immediately hearing it, I felt timeless. I think that's the best way for me to describe how it felt to me. It says, "I need you, baby, and if it's quite all right, I need you, baby, to warm a lonely night. I need you." Everything about that song felt perfect. It just felt like, I don't know, it's just, that song will be played for probably the rest of my life. I love that song. I love that song. It's just, that was awesome. That was an awesome track. I don't have very much to say about it, except for we only have one more, which is called Tell Him. Let's get into it. Tell Him. That was a great closer to the song. It's had some awesome harmonies in there. Had an awesome vocal performance by Lauren again. I kind of figured out who I was talking to. So it sounded like she was talking to a lover and to Jesus. As she could see throughout the album, there was the biblical references. And I think she was saying that because she can see love in both of those. Like the love that she has for Jesus and the love Jesus has for her. And the love that she has for her lover and the love that her lover has for her. It's like a duality right there, right? Really enjoyed that song a lot. Thought that was an awesome way to end the album. And then that brings us to our ranking of the album. If I were to have to give this album a ranking, I'm going to give it a strong 92%. That is a monster, monster score. And I thoroughly enjoyed this album. There was a lot of songs that will be in my rotation for the far, far, far foreseeable future. They were absolute awesome performances by Lauryn Hill. And let me know in the comments if you have any other Lauryn Hill albums that you think I should listen to, because if they're all like this, I'll be listening to her a lot more. But yeah, let me know down in the comments if you have any other recommendations for Lauryn Hill or any other albums. I appreciate you watching throughout the whole video with me. We greatly appreciate it if you could drop a like and subscribe to the channel. It helps us out. If you would like to see the full uncut version of this, it is on the Patreon linked in the description. And check me out on all my other socials down there as well. With all that being said, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out. Stay safe out there, guys.